So my significant other, her name is really sweet, so it goes by. You can have more than you have, because you can become more than you are. But unless you change who you are, then you can't have what you want. Then I guess, instead of focusing on what you want, why wouldn't you become the person that qualifies to have what you want? Hey folks, welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Sammy, back again with another video. In today's video, it's going to be a Q&A session. And I'm gonna answer all your questions. Yeah, the ones you've asked me and the ones you still have in your head, I'll answer everything. So let's get right into it.
Who is Samuel?
Samuel is a young black kid from Africa and specifically Ghana. Yeah, my Ghana people. And I'm just here to let you know that you can use the power of your mind to get whatever you want in your life.
What do you understand by purpose?
Purpose is you having a goal or an intention to create something for your life and leaving something before you leave this earth. Yeah.
What is your primary business?
I'm currently doing e-commerce, selling products online.
Do you have any other digital products running, or you're only into YouTube?
So I'm going to be introducing a couple of them, but the first one that will be coming very soon is how to sell products online, and that will be coming very soon. So guys, watch out. You guys should get it when it comes, because it's gonna blow your mind.
Who are your mentors?
Okay, my mentors are Wesley Virgin, Jim Rohn, Myron Golden, Bob Proctor. Come on, they're a lot. But my core are Wesley Virgin, Jim Rohn. Yeah.
Tell me the story about how you met Virgin Wesley.
So I actually saw an ad of him for I think like 3 months, and I never clicked on the ad. But then the day I clicked on the ad, everything changed for me, because I bought one of his products and he helped me change my mind. And I feel like this is my purpose now, to help you change your mind to get whatever you want in life.
How do you stay motivated?
Okay, I just do this by always feeding my mind with personal development stuff. So I just feed my mind, same way that we feed ourselves every day, feed my mind every day, consistently.
Do affirmations really work, or is it just a way to keep us hoping and pushing?
Okay, affirmations, it's a bit tricky, because you're already saying affirmations every day. So you're already telling yourself stuff that maybe don't empower you. Maybe you say stuff that empower you, but then most of the times what happens is we say stuff that don't empower us. And we are constantly saying stuff to ourselves, and we are affirming it in our lives. So to answer the question, affirmations work if you are conscious of it or unconscious of it. But now, being really conscious of it will help you get the results that you want for your life.
What is a typical Saturday morning like for you?
Okay, on Saturdays, I basically shoot videos all day. But when I wake up, I say some prayers to the Lord God Almighty, and thank him for a good night's sleep. And yeah, I do my chores, you know, do some laundry and stuff like that. And I play the keyboard at church, so later in the day, I go for rehearsals, yeah.
Who's your significant other, and how do you balance your social and private life?
So my significant other, her name is really sweet, so it goes by, you know what guys, I'll tell you guys on the next video. So if you want to know my significant other, please watch the next video and subscribe to the channel, okay? Subscribe to the channel. And yeah, I decided to keep that private, because you know, when you live like a public life, you treasure solitude. So I just decide not to put myself out there so much. I try my best to do what I can do. Yeah.
This is a speed round. mention the very few words that come to mind. What makes you smile?
When somebody says something about me that I never said it, said to anybody. Yeah.
Now, what scares you the most?
Snakes, but most importantly, not being able to fulfill your purpose on earth before you leave.
What's the most interesting thing you've done, read, or seen this week?
Oh, okay. So I actually went to this Korean restaurant. It was really nice. I don't know what it's called, but it tastes like African food and I really liked it. And also I read something this week which really blew my mind. It says that in order, learning about something is not the same as knowing about something. And that really got me thinking, yeah.
What is your favorite band or song?
You already know, Caveman.
What's your favorite place to eat?
Clementine, it's the best.
Do you sing in the shower?
Yeah, I'm a good singer, I do.
What did you want to be when you were a kid?
A pilot.
Can you drop some value for us?
Okay, I would like to drop some value for you guys. And this value is from Affirm Prosperity. Guys, if you've not checked out Affirm Prosperity, go to the Instagram page at Affirm Prosperity and you get, if you're an entrepreneur, business owner, or somebody who just wants to get motivated every day, we drop content for you guys. And I want to read something from Affirm Prosperity right now. And it says that change in the right direction feels wrong in the moment. And this is from Myron Golden. I read this from a book that I'm currently reading, which is called Boss Moves. Okay, so that's about it, guys. Done with the questions. If you have more questions for me, let me know in the comment section. And if you want to know my significant other, subscribe to the channel and I'll tell you in the next video. Peace out. Love you guys. Peace.